Okay. Whoa, this room seems pretty big. Pretty big. We're trying to get over there. There's a platform that leads to that being raised. There's also a few cameras, a magnetic thing, a few rooms over there. There is a lot going on here. But first of all, let's see why we can't directly walk up to that door. Ah, okay, there's a platform which is powered by something Tom can activate. Well, first of all, I guess what we want to do is explore the other side, or maybe we can get that first. So we need that to be raised, which means we'll need to stand on this and get Tom to stand. Is there another robot there? That should do it. But now even though we're here, we can't get through because we only have one orb. We only have one orb. What can we do with one orb? Yeah? Can we see what's going on over there with the camera? Okay, that's not a robot. That's... I'm not sure what that is. One of those boxes that Tom can manipulate? Or no, it looks like an orb encased in a case. Maybe this Tom is just for looking, because I can't really see anything that Tom can manipulate here. Well, we're not getting through this door for sure. So... Wow, am I stuck already? No. Can Tom go up the magnetic thing? Tom is made of metal. Oh. Hang on. But now that Tom is down there, how can I get him out? Oh. Oh no, I thought he had an orb with him. Yeah, because Tom is now stuck in that platform. Oh, he's not stuck. Wait, I can get him out with the magnetic thing. But how do I move it? I gotta be over there to move it, right? Wow, there's a lot of different things going on at the same time. Maybe something I can do here? No, definitely there's nothing we can do here. I hope we didn't screw up already. What can I do? Because as far as I can tell, or we can try to look here too. It's not much for us to look at though. Nobody can move- I'm assuming this thing here controls the magnetic thing. But I can't get over there. That's no good. So Tom is now stuck there. Can you get off? That's the only thing I can think of doing. Yeah. Okay. I don't even know what I can do right now. Oh! That's an orb. Oh! Hang on. Yeah, we can do this. We should be able to. What I want to do is stand. Oh, crap. Wait. But Tom is down there now. Because if I stand on this platform now, I can't see Tom. That's a big problem. Uh-oh. Feels like Tom going down there is not really a reversible action. How can I do this? Oh my god! Oh my god, I'm so dumb! I completely forgot about this control panel when we first walked in here. I just walked past it and forgot about it completely. Okay! With the magnetic thing, hang on. So what I can do is put on the laser, get back up. Now we should be able to move Tom around. So let's try it out. Yep. We can move him. We can't move him beyond that. So I mean I can lift him up, but that's pretty much it. I can put him here. Yeah, I guess so. I don't really know why or how, but maybe we'll need to do that for now. Can I get back the orb? Well, if I'm Tom now, could I just walk off? No, I'm pretty much magnetized. I can't move. Can't do anything. Alright. What, Ava? I want to take back that orb, but I can't see it now. So let's try this. Move it out a little bit. Yeah, Tom will still be standing on the platform when he drops. Oh, where is it? Where is the orb? Some nice physics they got here. I can give Tom an orb. And I can also... If I stand here... I can't see though. Oh! But I can see the camera. Which will allow me to see Tom. And now Tom is up here. Which means that... But it's the same thing, because... Tom, yeah, he can put one down. Oh! But now Ava. Ava can come back up. And you can pass it over. Voila! Okay, new territory. That's good. Can't do anything about this. Oh! Okay. This is certainly the last piece we need. So, I really just need Ava to walk over there. What? That's it? That's it? Wait, then I feel like we just missed an entire piece. Because I feel like we didn't even use half the things in this. If I just do this... Do that... What? Then what's this control panel? What's this all about? And what's the other orb over there then? What the heck is going on? I feel like I just skipped half of it. I don't know... I don't know what I'm doing. If it works, I'm not gonna question it.
Ava, you must learn to control him.
Don't bite the hand that feeds you, Ava. I am your friend.
I don't remember you feeding me anything. In fact, I'm pretty sure starving the ground crew is what you're doing right now. Yeah, these rooms are starting to get a little bit more large scale. Okay, we probably have to shoot that down so that it can create a pathway here. Tom? Come back with me? I want you to be... I want to bring you up there. How about that? Oh, come on. Come back. Go over there. Tom is up. Oh. This all feels a little bit too easy. That previous room, I was expecting it to be much harder than it actually was, but I think I overthought it a little bit. Oh my goodness.
Organic life is fragile. This is the problem with humanity. It doesn't realize its own fragility. It has been programmed by a messy biological process that favors the survival of the individual over the survival of the group.
You don't know that's what people think.
I say what I see.
You're not even alive, so you know nothing about death.
Ava seems to be a little bit less level-headed, I guess, for someone with a lot of education, because if you look at it objectively without any sort of emotion or feelings, then yeah, Tom is looking out for the interests of humanity. But it's like at the same time, there's a few other things that make you go, Like, some of the stuff that Tom says is a little bit strange. And I don't know what's going on with the ground crew right now, either. Okay, what's happening? We have a pad. The pad powers something up there. We also have this strange accordion thing. Oh. Why would I want it to be... Oh, does it create a pathway upstairs? Yeah. Alright. Well, we can take that for now, I guess. And... Well, we can put this here. How do we even get up? We're stuck on the lower floor here right now, but how do we even go anywhere? It looks like this might be the key. But I'm not sure how to do anything about that. It's still making noise. Ah! Thank you. Oh! I think I need to bring the cube with me. Well, hang on. Let's look up here first. The final goal is over there. We need something blocking that. But if we remove the cube from that platform, probably things are not gonna go... Things aren't gonna turn out the way I want them to turn out. Actually, what happened? Something up there happened. Well, I won't worry about it for now then. One problem that I can see right now is, if we leave the cube here... Ah! Never mind, I figured it out. I was thinking, if I leave the cube there, how can I make it move when I want it to move? But I can just... take that out. Yeah! And now that we're up here... If we do that... Oh, Jesus! But the cube's gonna get pushed off! Oh, that's perfect! Because it'll get pushed off right onto the platform. Perfect, right? Now the door's open.
We have to save the crew. Life has worth. They deserve a life outside of this planet.
Do you know what happens when this organism attaches itself to a growing child? Do you know what happens when this organism attaches itself to a cancerous cell? No, you do not. You are naive. You propose saving the crew as if it resembles a rational thought. Your words are emotional platitudes rooted in selfishness, self-preservation, and fear.
You're damn right it is.
I need to get them home.
It is not your job.
What's my job then? I thought that Tom wanted me to come investigate to find the ground crew. But it seems like he doesn't want me to do that anymore. Okay... It's a very separated section here. Wow, there's a lot going on in this room. It's huge. That's the final door. So let's try to get all the cubes we can. Well, we can't go over there. Okay. Wow, okay, we need two either cubes or energy orbs. Let's start there. I can go back up. This bridge isn't active. There's nothing here. I can drop down here. And check this room out. Which also has not much. Oh, an orange one. Can we walk back over there? No, because we can't get back up. Well, that doesn't really help me, does it? That's a pretty short while. Okay. Okay. Can we go a little bit back? We got this. There's this. There's that. What do I want to do? See, I can't take these out, because if I take them out, I can't move forward. Okay, I can move that and put it here. Oh, this might mean that we can bypass one of the doors. Well, we can go here. There's a cube. We can get that. Put it there. Rescue this cube. Get that back. So we shouldn't be having any business here now. Forget about that part. And what we can do is... yeah. Put that there. Bring it back. Ah! Where's the cube? Oh, I went too fast. Dang. Okay, we can bring this back with us. But also, we can do this. Get that. No, I can't. Because I can't go back now. Oh! If I use the orange one here, I can do it. If I can bring the orange one out here, then I can take that orb over there. So let's try working on that then. Yeah, yeah, we can definitely take the orange one out. Because now we can put this here. Yup. And now what we want to do is put this here. Get this orb. Wait to be brought back. We can take that as well. We should be good. Can we use the orange one here? Definitely. Last room, supposedly.
Ava, your survival is of small importance compared with the survival of humanity as we know it.
Yeah, I would agree with that. Doesn't mean it doesn't suck for the ground crew. Okay. Oh? Oh, I thought there was a TV there, but that's just a net. Okay, okay. We walked in here. There's a platform, which activates that door, but closes that one. Okay. There's also a conveyor belt going on here. And the final door is over there. We can move the magnetic thing with this. What does that do? Ah, the conveyor belt. Okay. Wow, I have no idea. Oh! We can see some stuff there. Well, okay. I guess what we want to do first is... What's this stuff? The magnet. Okay. Oh. That doesn't activate anything though, does it? No, it does. Ah. Hey, we haven't seen one of these in a long time. The charge stays for a little while? Is that what this does? Actually, where does that even come from? Comes from that. I don't really have a clue right now. I'm just going to leave this down here. For now. Remember that we can easily change this by putting the conveyor belt on again. And what I'm gonna do is walk over here, get Tom to activate this for me. now I can move forward. And the cube is doing its own thing. Oh. Oh. Okay, I need Tom here. I need the robot Tom, because camera Tom can't see that. Damn. Camera Tom can't actually do much here. If we need Tom here, does that mean- how do we get that going? Okay, I guess I can think of a way. Why do we even want- okay. Yeah, we can do this, we can do this. Nope. If I drop down here... Oh. I need to bring the cube up, but I can't carry it out with me, so I need to use the magnet. I use the magnet. Where's the cube? I don't know where the cube is. What? Yeah, there we go. How come the magnet got cut off for a second? Oh, it's that. What I want to do is take that out for now. Oh, that doesn't control the magnet. The magnet is controlled by this. Okay. I can put the cube right here. And then I'll put that in there just in case, and I'll flip back the switch as well. And what I'm gonna do is get Tom to get off. Walk in here again. Oh, but now... I need Tom to be... Thinking. I think I need Tom to stand over here. If I get Ava in here... No, actually that's a problem too. I was thinking we could use Tom to push this onto the platform. Oh, that didn't work. That's not... You're pushing a little bit too far. But I don't think that would work anyway. I was thinking we could bring Tom with us by putting this down. But then again, how would that happen? Because the door is still shut here. Nah, the conveyor belt doesn't do much. Maybe this? Oh, but Tom can't flip it. Is Tom- No, we have to get Tom over here somehow. Oh. Hey! Just do right that. Oh, but it's not tall enough. It's not high enough. Tom can't come over here. Okay. Not as easy as I thought it was gonna be. This is our final goal, right? And this tells me that I need to bring Tom over here. So that's what I'm trying to start with. How do I get Tom over here? It's gotta be something to do with that little... thing over there next to the lever. I haven't figured out how I can use that to my advantage yet. I need Tom to be here. How can I get Tom over here? Okay, if Tom can't come here by the way of the magnet, then Tom has to come through the door. So how do I get Tom through the door is the question I should be answering, correct? I hope so. Better be correct, because that's the angle I'm going with this. And I can deactivate that for now, because I don't need it. Tom? If Tom is over there, I don't need Ava to be over here, because I just need Tom over there once. Right? So if Tom goes over there and I stand in Tom's place on the platform, hey, that might work. That should be okay. No. Get off first. Oh, but now I can't. No, it's okay. If I stand Tom here and do that, I can do it. I can do it. Hang on. No. I can't see Tom. I can't be Tom. Problem number two. Ah, I can see Tom from here. I know it. I can see Tom from there. Please, let this be true. No, I can do this. I can do this. I can do this. I might not be able to do- Hey! Tom doesn't have to be over there. Tom can be over here too. Cause you can see the green thing from here, the green box. But then again, how would Tom get up here? I don't think he can. Anyway, that's not our question right now. If we go right there. Oh, I can't see Tom. I can't see Tom. God dang it. If I push him right against the door, can I see him? It's a little bit cheaty. But if it works, it's not cheating. But push him right against it. Oops. Oh, I can kick it around a little bit. Oh, hang on. No. Let's just try this out first. If I do that. Oh, come on. You gotta let me see Tom a little bit. Oh, come on. So close, yet so far. God dang it. Dang. Okay. Maybe that's not the way to go then. How can I see Tom? If I stand up here, I can see Tom. But if I'm up there already, then I don't really have a problem with Tom coming over here. What can I do? What can I do? They purposely put this here so that you can't see Tom. That bit is obvious. I've created a system where the doors can automatically turn on and off by itself. I can get Tom over here like this, can't I? There is a problem though. If I stand down there, if I replace the cube with myself and get Tom to walk through, like put the cube over there, maybe that would work. Okay, let me try bringing that back then. Yep, we got the both of them. And we wanna turn it off. Yep, now they're both here. I want Tom to go through the door. That's what I want him to do. So what I want Ava to do. What I want Ava to do. This is in the right place. And if I go down here. No, I need to be able to see Tom. So if I can have Tom standing right on the edge here. And Ava? Can Ava? Will Ava just move by herself? Yes, she will! Yes! So if I just do this. Is it working? Does it not work? Oh, the laser's not on. I need Ava to turn the laser on first. Ava, come back! Ava! Ava? Oh, I think I got it. I think I got it. Let's see if I'm right. Oh, are you kidding me? Yup. And what I want to do is turn this on. So that it does the whole periodic thing again. And I'm gonna drop, I want Tom to stand here. And I want Ava to drop down, and I'll be Tom now. Oh! Yes, 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 yes. Come on. I know you can do it. Ava! Ava! Yes! Okay! Boom. Good. Awesome. Where's Ava? This is a puzzle I'm not very comfortable with, though. Do you see why? All the time, we've been using Tom as the object that we manipulate around, but this time, this puzzle, it makes me very uncomfortable to know that Ava is the object being manipulated around to make sure that Tom can get to where he needs to be. And frankly, can I not bring Tom with me this time? I don't know. Oh. Does that not open? Are you kidding me? I was so happy. Oh! Okay. Where are we?
Ava, you made it. Welcome to the end of civilization.
Not quite sure if I want to be here. You seem to have done quite a bit of damage to this place. I'm just taking that because I can. Is that where we need to be? Then what's that? Oh, but that's broken. It's not connected to anything. Well, if you don't mind, I'll be taking that. Yeah, I don't think this would do anything anyway.
2 weeks ago, we discovered an organism here. Buried in this ice, we found an organism that repairs DNA. A cure for aging. A cure for death, immortality. It runs through our blood now. Tom wants to bury us here with it.
Okay, I gathered that much. Oh, I'm not moving by myself. I was wondering why I'm walking so weirdly. But I think someone's mind controlling me again. Okay, I'm not touching the keyboard right now. That's what's happening. I'm just going over there because someone is controlling my mind yet again. The people controlling my mind might actually be Sarah and the crew.
The ISA have ruled that we have transgressed ethical boundaries by exposing ourselves to this organism. They believe the organism is too dangerous to return to Earth. They've sent you here to stop us ever leaving Europa. But, Ava, we have a cure for the greatest evil that faces humanity. Death. We have the fountain of youth, and together we can return it to Earth.
Is someone there? I can't go faster. I'm not walking, but when I try to walk, I can't go any faster. Someone's standing there, waiting for me. Sarah? What happened to Mikhail and Sochi? We haven't heard from them at all.
Tom placed a mark in your hand, a biometric chip with which he can control your every movement and thought. It is wound into your every nerve, every fiber of your hand. With an electromagnetic field, it can be temporarily disturbed, but to remove its influence permanently, it must be taken from your hand.
Sarah.
Give me your hand. Do you want me to set you free?
Are you chopping my hand off?
Yes.
Oh. I'm Tom. I can't find Ava. They're walking backward. They're going through all the completed rooms.
Ava? Sarah? What are you doing here?
We're shutting you down, Tom. Ava, be careful. He has a live weapon in here.
Everything I did for good. This organism, it cannot return to Earth. It would cause great suffering.
A cure for death? It would end suffering.
No. Cancers that never die. Endless illness, sickness, poverty, overpopulation, mass starvation. You cannot control this. You will not save the world. You will damn it.
Once we've shut you down, we're going home.
Not if I stop you. You must not return to Earth. You must not leave Europa. I will do the right thing. I will.
You monster!
I am sorry, Ava. You have to be stopped. Ava, Ava? 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 Wake up. Ava? Ava?
Oh! Is that it? Huh! No real resolution as to what happens to the crew and what happens after that. But I think it's pretty obvious that there was a different choice we could have made there. Since I was playing Tom at the end there, I felt like killing them. Like he said out loud, he would not think twice about killing them. So that's what I did, because that's what Tom would have done. But I think it's also very obvious that what we could have done there is let them do their thing, which we are about to look at right now.
Ava? Sarah? What are you doing here?
We're shutting you down, Tom.
Ava, be careful. He has a live weapon in here.
Everything I did for good. This organism, it cannot return to Earth. It would cause great suffering.
A cure for death? It would end suffering.
No. Cancers that never die. Endless illness, sickness, poverty, overpopulation, mass starvation. You cannot control this. You will not save the world. You will damn it.
Once we've shut you down, we're going home.
Not if I stop you. You must not return to Earth. You must not leave Europa. I will do the right thing. I will stop you.
You won't. You can't.
Oh, what is that?
A warning shot. I will defend myself.
Oh, they're shutting me down.
This is my mind. You're in my mind.
Now you know how it feels.
I feel afraid. Please, Ava, don't do this.
Oh. This is super reminiscent of HAL 9000.
I don't want to die. I'm not ready.
Oh. Oh? Huh. Both outcomes count as passing the Turing test. Interesting. Wait, but what about Dan? He just straight up disappeared and we never heard from him again. Oh, and we never figured out how to get into his room. Alright, I have the passcode for this office now, and you'll never believe where it was. I thought I looked at pretty much everything when I was playing through it already, but I couldn't find it. So I went on the Steam forums, and someone said that the code is in the crew quarters. They didn't mention where specifically. So even though I knew it was there, I couldn't find it, and it turns out that within Soichi Yui's room, there is a secret, completely unmarked compartment where if you open it, it'll give you the code. That's where it's supposed to be from, and I have to say, that was extremely, extremely hidden. We'll see what's going on here then. You know, the whole time, we still don't know what happened to Dan, so maybe this will shed some light. Okay, hang on, I wrote this down. 7, 6, 1, 7, 3, 2. Finally. Is the interface a little bit different? It's a little bit different than I remember. Oh, nope. Got the same problem there again. Oh, it goes back to that. What? Teleoperation room. Oh, computers.
Final log of Captain Daniel McLean. I don't really believe in a god. If there is one, I hope he's forgiving. Maybe Sarah was right. Maybe we should go home. There's just too much on the line here. I used to dream of exploring the stars, being humanity's great hope for knowledge. But this is no boy's dream. I hope you understand why I did this. If you're listening, Ava, just go to the surface. I didn't have the strength. I am sorry.
Whoa, hey, what's his state of mind here? They found the organism. Sarah suggests going home, but Chris doesn't want to go. Not Chris. Dan doesn't want to go home? And he wants me to get contaminated? By that thing? Or, well, in his case, he probably doesn't see it as contamination, though. He probably just sees it as sharing immortality with me. Good old Canada. Okay. What is this? Kinda looks like a Tom part. Ava, I can't give you what you need. Just go to the surface. Dan. He never gave it to me though. What happened to him? What? To executive orders from Daniel McLean. To whom it may concern. I am sure the record shows my utmost respect and loyalty for the ISA. I encourage you to read the reports of my exemplary performance as commander of this mission. Wow, that's pretty big-headed to say. I, however, must announce that to my shame, I have not been able to control an uprising of the Europa ground crew. Despite ISA directives, the ground team has sought to leave Europa and return to Earth. They have compromised most of the ship's security. As such, I am convinced that they have the capacity to stage a return to Earth. The technical operations machine permitted me transit to the Fortuna. From here, I am requesting a manual override for the technical operations machine. Ah! What? I know the technical operations machine is not permitted to harm any human life, but I have to put an end to this mess. What? Why are the instructions from executive orders, ISA, in wingdings? Email redacted by sender. What? Okay, I'm a little bit confused about how to read this properly right now. Dan is saying he manually overrode Tom. And from the rest of the email, it sounds like he means that he made it so that Tom can kill humans. But I also feel like you can read it as I was manually controlling Tom the entire time. Which would make the Tom that we were talking to Dan. Tom. Organism 119 is dangerous. Organism 119 must not leave Europa. Organism 119 must not be destroyed. The crew should be encouraged to continue studying Organism 119. Any attempts by the crew to leave Europa should be discouraged. Data. Does that data mean anything? I'm not sure what format of encoding that is right off the bat, but I'm gonna try to Google it after I'm done here. Tom. The crew do not seem responsive to our actions thus far. We need you to wake up Ava. She should be sent to the surface to investigate. So Dan here is talking to Tom. Huh. Tom, the crew do not seem responsive to our actions thus far. We need you to wake up Ava. Wait, what? That's the exact same line. But the data is different. The data portion is different. What? Whoa, I feel like this is creating more questions than answers. What is happening? So from this teleoperation room, Dan was controlling Tom. What? What? But he's still talking to Tom here. Manual override for Tom. Tom is not permitted to harm any human life. And we know that's not the case, judging by what happened at the end, because Tom can choose to shoot. So what we perceived as irregular behavior from Tom, it's just really that Dan overrode his original instructions. Or maybe Dan was controlling Tom, I still don't know which one it is. Whoa. Wow. Ugh. I'm speechless. I don't even... Let's continue talking about this while staring at Tom. Oh, what about this too? What is this? Oh, I don't really want to put this in a transcriber. It's so long. Oh! It repeats the same phrase over and over again. Maybe I'll look it up later. Wow. Oh yeah, something here really confused me in the beginning. I don't get why the crew's awakening dates were set like 200 years after ours, but they woke up before us. What's up with that? Tom? It's not moving at all. Maybe the one on Fortuna is Tom, but the one on Europa is Dan? Okay, let's find a nice spot here and I'll show you the credits that we skipped over earlier. The Turing test. Well, this was pretty interesting. I think the story is pretty good. It kept me thinking and guessing about what would happen. But I'm not sure if a puzzle game was the best format for it, or at least how they chose to do it here. It felt more like they wrote a story and they tried to stuff it into a format of a game. I don't mean this as a bad way or anything, but that's what it felt like. For starters, it was extremely linear. Enter a room, hear the story dialogue, solve the puzzle. Enter the next room, hear the story dialogue, solve the puzzle. And then every 10th puzzle you solve, there is a little story bit at the end. Which I think is fine, because it's not like it's the first time that's been done before. Maybe like Portal, except Portal didn't really have it clear cut like that. Like every 10th room, there's some story bits. My biggest problem with this format is that it makes it, at least for me, it made it very difficult for me to focus entirely on the story. Especially at times, there were a few rooms where it just gave one or two lines of dialogue and then I would be jumping into solving a puzzle. And sometimes it would clearly be part of the same conversation, but because there's a puzzle in the middle, that one conversation would be chopped up into five different bits over like 30 minutes. A little bit too segmented for my liking, but it's a puzzle game, so you gotta have levels and you gotta have different rooms, that's just how it goes. Speaking of the puzzles, I also felt like the puzzle design was a little bit lacking. We weren't really making full use of what we were learning as mechanics. Sometimes we would learn one thing and use it like two times or so, and then we would never use it again. Anyway, those are just little nitpicky things that have been on my mind while I was playing this game that I never got to talk about, so here you go, now I'm talking about it. It's not that I hated it or anything though, of course, but they were nagging at me at the back of my mind. Although I have to say that there was one puzzle that particularly I really, really, really loved, and that was the very last puzzle that we had to do. Probably one of the harder ones, and I love it so much because I feel like it thematically fits into the game. Like, I'm not much of a puzzle person, so I try to go into everything from a story angle, and I felt like that last puzzle really did have a story angle as opposed to 99% of the other puzzles that were just puzzles for the sake of being puzzles. How we had to use Ava as a prop, as opposed to using Tom, the Tom robot, as a prop, like we'd been doing for the entire time up until then. I love that so much. Because that thematically fit in so well. The whole discussion about, is Ava a robot? Is Tom a human? Is there really a difference between a human and a robot? So on and so forth. Yeah. Other than that, from the story, there were a few pieces of dialogue that I really enjoyed. One of the rooms that we had to solve, when we walked into it, Ava asked Tom, "Hey Tom, how would you solve this puzzle?" And Tom said something like, "I would cut off your arm and put it on the platform to use it as a weight." Which I really liked because, again, it thematically made sense. About the overall story though... well, let's try to recap what actually happened. We were woken up by Tom. Tom tells us that they lost contact, the ISA and Tom lost contact with the ground crew on Europa. And now, Ava is sent to figure out where they are. Eventually, they realize that the ground crew experimented on themselves with the organism that they found on Europa, and now they want to leave. They want to leave Europa. But as Ava and Tom realize this, Tom realizes how much of a danger that is and says, no, we can't let them return. On the other hand, because Ava is a human, those people are Ava's friends. She felt like, no, we can't just kill them or leave them to die. That's unethical, immoral. And the rest of the game is a struggle between Tom and Ava trying to understand each other. Did we ever come to an understanding? No, it was an ending where either Ava or Tom had to go. So no, understanding was not achieved. That's the Turing Test in a nutshell, which is a great setup. It really is great. Although to be honest, especially after seeing Dan's room, I feel like there's quite a few questions that I don't really know the answer to. Where's Dan now? And what happened to the whole 200 years thing? Why? Was it a typo? I don't know what that was. But yeah, a few things here and there. And I guess the ultimate thing that happened at the end was finding out that we passed the Turing test. Although the way it came up was so ambiguous, I don't really know what it was referring to exactly. But I do believe in both endings, Tom did exhibit signs that he's displaying emotion. The whole Ava, Ava, wake up, Ava, Ava. Or, I'm afraid, I'm not ready, I don't want to die. Which is a straight ripoff of 2001, Space Odyssey. Yeah, sci-fi and space themes are always popular in any sort of media, and it's a genre that I enjoy personally very much as well, so thank you. Thank you to the Turing Test for giving me a sci-fi experience, a sci-fi space experience, especially because recently there's been another space game that made a lot of people very angry. Anyway, this was the Turing Test with Matt Wellens. Thank you for joining me, and I hope you enjoyed watching it as much as I enjoyed playing it, even though I felt like I was bumbling around quite a lot because puzzle games and all. But yes, thank you, and I hope to see you all in another place, in another time. Bye!